Dig the hipster.
In my last video, I showed this shot of a wax slug striking the knee of Chakotay. While many people probably fixated only on the impact, what is the really cool thing that I like looking at is the external ballistics, which is the flight from the gun barrel to the target. That's where all the really cool stuff really happens. So basically what happened here is I inadvertently created a stabilized wax slug, since wax slugs normally tumble randomly through the air. Most shotgun shells use a one-piece plastic wadding, such as this. It has a gas piston, a shock absorber, and the shot cup, which holds the actual shot. However, Federal does things differently and uses a two-piece wadding. The bottom piece is the gas piston and has a little stem that acts as the shock absorber. It just kind of crushes under the G-shock when you shoot it. The shot cup is relatively simple, four slits on it that cause the pedals to open up and act like a speed brake while the shot continues flying on. And normally a wax slug will release from the shot cup the moment it leaves the barrel too. Now the pedals did open up and act like speed brakes, but they also stabilized the slug. Because I got the mixture probably too hot and that steel shot probably fused to the plastic shot cup, it just never released. Normally to achieve drag stabilization, you want the drag way behind the center of gravity, but here it's almost on the center of gravity. So looking at this, you would almost expect the slug just to flip around, take the path of least resistance, but basically what we're seeing here is almost like watching a badminton birdie flying at supersonic speeds backwards.
Okay, printer, hit it! Dead on target. Look at that. You can see the hole.
Oh yeah.
Right there.
She's a beaut.
That's perfect, man. Dead on target.
Now it's one thing to have one freak occurrence, and you can kind of dismiss that as a freak occurrence, but to be able to repeat it over and over again is a different story. For the test, I made two different batches. I made a set of orange slugs and blue slugs. I wasn't sure which would show up better on camera. The drag stabilization phenomenon only occurred with the blue slugs. Now I have to say the stability of flight is the remarkable thing here. It doesn't enhance anything though. The last thing you want is to slow down the slug. You have four giant speed brakes, basically quadrupling the profile of the slug, and that's not really what you want in a shotgun slug.
You hit it!
Now here, Mike is using one of the orange slugs. It's separated from the shot cup just fine. However, we can see it tumbling end over end quite a bit during flight. However, it was still pretty accurate. And that Nokia phone is a pretty small target, especially considering Mike only shot the gun about 5 times prior to this. A tumbling slug just looks wrong, and a lot of people think you can improve upon that, but it's accurate, and that's what you want. Now instead of an orange slug, I gave Mike a blue slug here, not knowing there was any difference between the two. He had no problem hitting it the first time with the orange slug, but the blue slug gave us some problems.
No challenge. That's negative, drill sergeant.
One more time, Mike, you got this.
Sure, the slug is flying nose first, and you would think that would make the slug more accurate. But in essence, what we've done is added more complexities to the equation. So if the little flaps aren't absolutely perfect, everything isn't perfectly balanced, well, all those complexities can work against you.
Keep those goddamn flies off the end of my...
No excuses.
I think it's safe to say that at this point Mike is as frustrated as a hula dancer in a forest fire.
Where are they going? I think one of them are breaking apart or something.
I have no idea.
No, yeah. You hit it with shrapnel.
Now in this shot we see something a little different going on. The shot cup this time stayed attached to the slug, but only for about 15 yards, then it released. And of course, that doesn't help the accuracy at all. It is kind of interesting to see how fast that shot cup is bouncing off that piece of wood, probably traveling about 600 feet per second. But this is a really fluky shot because that slug appears to be flying stable even without the drag stabilization at that point.
Hey, hit it!
So Mike was completely frustrated, so we're gonna let Nick shoot this time. And I gave him an orange slug without knowing it.
Look at that shit.
Clean. So our conclusion is that it's not the round, it's the shooter.
I could have hit it.
Hell of a shot, dude. Nick, I was a little late on that. I'd
Nick's
my
got
Instagram story.
So no, it wasn't the shooter, it was the slug. After all, Mike, come on. And this shot is a virtual mirror image of Mike's shot using the orange slug. And once again, the orange slug is tumbling along, nothing to stabilize it, no spin, no fins, no nothing, and it's relatively accurate. The wax slug is about as crude as you could possibly get as far as improvised slugs go. You don't need a mold, you just heat up wax and shot and dump it into the shell. That's all you do. Now, including this shell, a wax slug costs about 25 cents to make. Yeah, you could use epoxies or whatever and turn a 25 cent slug into a dollar slug real quick. Wax is extremely cheap, often free if you steal your kids' crayons. It doesn't put off a bunch of nasty fumes like epoxies would. And you can create giant batches of wax slugs without worrying about the wax permanently setting up on you like epoxy would. Now, from a technical standpoint, it is pretty cool that I accidentally created some stabilized wax slugs, but in reality the benefits were about as useful as a pint of bourbon at a Shriners convention. It didn't make the slugs better, it didn't make them faster, it didn't make them more accurate, it added no benefit at all. Now, if we proved anything, we proved that keeping things simple and keeping things cheap is often the best way to go. Now, the proof is that every single orange slug that we shot landed on target. Even though it was tumbling around and it looked very awkward, they were still superior to this. Thanks for watching.